You know, we all have concerns about the falling price of oil and what that does to our economy. Here at the city, we have been concentrating on providing good services, and we have a good business plan. We're very flexible. We've built reserves, and if we have to, we can adjust our business plan to meet the economy as it develops.
The drop in oil price has brought about change in our community. At the port, however, we've continued to see industry want to locate here, and we have three major projects under active consideration. This pause will also give us a chance to continue to work with the major industries that we've been able to attract to our community, along with the city, the EDC, and the two counties. And we have commitments that we must meet to them, and we pledge that we will do that.
First Alpine Texas LLC is investing $800 million in a cutting-edge iron ore processing plant in the Coastal Bend. The plant will run entirely on natural gas and will feature cutting-edge environmental control technology. Will the low energy and oil prices impact us? Yes, they will. In a positive way, because the lower the energy prices are, the better it is for our business model. We are going to be here for the long run.
The decline in oil prices will not affect Cheniere's business model. The LNG export facility is based on exporting natural gas to European markets, and many of those folks are using our supply as an insurance policy, basically diversification of supply and security of supply. So the decline in oil prices will not affect the business model.
One of the great things about what's going on in our region is the New Harbor Bridge. But the Harbor Bridge would not have become a reality had we not had great cooperation from TxDOT, City of Corpus Christi, Nueces County, San Patricio County, and the port, and particularly the help that we got from Senator Hinojosa, Todd Hunter, and Abel in making this become a reality, and all the help that we're getting, again, through TxDOT to make this bridge something that we'll all be very proud of.
I understand why people should be worried about the falling of oil prices, but for MNG Resins, we are not worried at all. The oil prices and the low prices of oil will impact positively our operations, but for sure we are not doing a $1 billion investment in the area only falling oil prices. Our business model is resilient. We will create 250 direct jobs in the area, and 700 indirect jobs will grow because of our plant. Our plant will be an environmental model. We have worked since the beginning with local stakeholders and entities to make an industrial plant not only reliable from a production standpoint, but environmentally savvy. What I have to tell the people of the Coastal Bend is to shake it off.
I'm happy that we found a way to free up $4.5 million in the Texas Military Value Revolving Loan Fund to benefit our military bases.
I'm excited about the improvements that are happening on the south side related to road. Airline Road, Yorktown, soon to be completed, and the recently approved Rockfield Road expansion.
I am happy for the passing of Proposition 1, the fixing of our streets, especially in my district. Citizens, you have made me happy.
Well, I'm happy Corpus Christi is growing. I'm happy that this is a great place to live. And I'm really happy that after 25 years, the Texas State Aquarium is finally bringing the sights, sounds, and wonderful animals of the Western Caribbean to the shores of Corpus Christi, Texas.
I'm happy about all the development on North Beach. Lexington has had its best attendance in 15 years. The aquarium's putting in a $50 million project. We have a plaza going in, and we have a Ferris wheel.
I'm happy because I work at the CVB with the most talented, diverse, fabulous, delightful, brilliant team in the entire world, and we brought 8.5 million people to Corpus Christi last year, the most beautiful city in the Milky Way galaxy.
Well, I am just happy to tell you that through the Corpus Christi Association of Realtors, we sold over $750 billion worth of property in 2014. Of course, we need new properties to keep this engine going, so let's bring it.
I'm happy that it takes 15 to 20 minutes to get anywhere in Corpus Christi. I'm happy that we were able to add police officers to our budget because they are here to protect our family and our city.
There are more people working in the Coastal Bend than ever before, and I'm happy we're creating new jobs every single day. You need a job? Move to Corpus Christi.
I am happy that I live in a city that is so beautiful with its beaches and bay and wonderful weather that people will spend a lot of money and travel thousands of miles to come visit here, and we get to live here every day.
I'm happy about that we have a diverse water supply, starting with the Mary Rhodes Phase 2 pipeline that's going to come online by the end of 2015, a plan for industrial desalination, and effluent reuse.
Let me tell you what I'm happy about. Corpus Christi is military country. We love the military in Corpus Christi. We've worked hard to create a plan called JLIS, and we're working every day to implement that plan to make sure the military not only stays in Corpus Christi, but grows its presence in the future.
In facilitating the 10-year industrial district agreement, the city won, the industrial district won, and I'm happy about that.
All right, let's go.
Okay, so you did a great job today. Yeah. What do you think about that?
Dear Mayor, you know, definitively this was not in my job description. Swing!
That was
Swing!
Way to go, bro.
He's got the moves.
So good!
Is that good?